Welcome to this series of videos on accessibility requirements for public procurement of ICT products and services in Europe, the EN301549 standard. This is the first video. It's sponsored by Microsoft and produced by Funke. My name is Susanna Loren. I'm an accessibility expert and I work at a Swedish consultancy called Funke. Since 2008, I have been involved as a technical expert in the joint standardizations effort called the Mandate 376, leading to the European Accessibility Procurement Standard. Public sector has an enormous purchasing power, and that means public procurement can actually change society. I believe that this standard on accessibility has the potential to change the lives of millions of persons with disabilities. No matter if you are a developer, a designer, a procurer, a website owner, or a content manager, we hope that you will be helped by this information. Together, we can make a difference. In this video, I will talk briefly about four different but related topics. First of all, accessibility. What is it? And who is it for? What are the target groups that benefit from accessibility? ICT. Or information and communication technology. That is a huge topic, of course. But what does it cover in this context? Procurement. It's a legal framework, but it can also be used as a tool to achieve a higher level of accessibility. The EN301549 standard. What is it all about? But let's start with the users. There are over 7 billion people on Earth. And every single one is unique. We look different, we act different, and we have different abilities. There are not two persons that are exactly the same, not even identical twins. Some are tall, some are short. Some can handle vast amounts of information really fast, and others struggle to handle it. There are people that need glasses, and others that cannot see at all. And some persons cannot move a muscle, while others can bend their bodies in all sorts of ways. We are all different, with our weaknesses and our strengths. If we live long enough, all of us will experience that our abilities change during life. This can be because of an illness, an accident, a disability, or while aging. But our abilities also change with the situation. This is part of being human. When you are under stress, you probably have problems with concentration and focus that are similar to a person with a cognitive disability. If you're using a digital device outdoors in bright sunlight, you might have a problem with the contrasts or lack of contrast that is very similar to what a person with a visual impairment experiences every day. And if you're trying to type something on your mobile device while on the bus or train, I'm sure you get irritated because the buttons that you are supposed to click are too small or they are placed too close together. This is very similar to the trouble a person with a motor impairment experiences. Technology has made a huge difference in everyone's life. Nowadays, you can do things more efficiently and independently. And the combination of ICT and assistive technology has made it possible to compensate for the lack of abilities. But this is only true if it's made right. This is where accessibility comes into play. Accessibility in ICT means that everyone, no matter of ability, can handle information and perform services. Accessibility is based on the concept of diversity and inclusion. The point is, what is necessary for some is really helpful for all of us. When we succeed in accessibility, users don't notice. It just works and everyone is happy. But when we fail, that's when we get frustration. Lack of accessibility can make it impossible for some users to complete a task. And it often leads to higher costs because many users need more support or even alternative ways to complete the task. Accessibility problems also mean that even users that can complete the process often need much more time to do so, which of course costs both time and money. When an organization develops a product or a service, it will only be effective if many can use it. Not making it accessible would be completely counterproductive. Everyone is speaking about ICT, but what do they really mean? In this context, information and communication technology, or ICT, is everything that has to do with communicating or handling information in some kind of device. Your phone is an ICT product, but also your computer, the ticket machine at the train station, the machine where you get your boarding pass at the airport, and the vending machine where you select a product to buy and pay for it. All of this is covered in the EN301549 standard. Today, almost everything can be considered ICT. We have smart cities, we live in smart homes, and even the refrigerator is connected to the internet. In the context of accessibility, we are only talking about ICT that is going to be used by humans. We are not concerned with the machine-to-machine interaction. When ICT is accessible, this means that persons with disabilities can study and work on equal terms with everyone else. Therefore, accessible ICT has a huge democratic impact on many people's lives. How does accessibility and procurement work together? Almost all ICT in public sector and beyond is procured. This goes for fixed solutions, customized products, and even things that does not yet exist, like a website or an e-service that is to be developed. Public spending takes up a very large portion of the value of the economic activity in a country, what is called the national GDP or gross domestic product. By putting the purchasing power of government behind accessibility, the market size for accessible features increases immensely. This means ICT suppliers will have an incentive to learn and provide accessibility to compete. Procurement is done to ensure best bang for the buck. But the procurement process is also where most requirements are set. This is where you need to start thinking about accessibility to be successful. The procurement process is only one part of the value chain in most ICT projects. We will look more into that in our next video. What is EN301549? The easiest way to explain it is to say that it's a common European standard for procurement of accessible ICT. The European standardization bodies were asked by the European Commission to produce a harmonized standard for ICT and accessibility. The goal was to set a common ground for public procurement in Europe, but the aim is, of course, to gradually make an impact in all sectors. Persons with disabilities have the same right to digital information and services no matter where they live. When all countries use the same requirements, more equal access is possible. But the EN standard is also important to support the inner market. Expert companies should have the possibility to sell their services throughout Europe. When it comes to the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, or WCAG, which is the international standard developed by the W3C, is the common denominator. The WCAG standard is included in full in the EN standard. But the EN301549 covers more than that. It covers all ICT. The EN standard will be implemented in procurement regulations in all European member states starting in 2016. The hope is that the private sector will follow more or less automatically, since suppliers will learn accessibility when selling to the public and then keep delivering the right way to other clients as well. In the private sector, suppliers that sell ICT to government will be incentivized to make the ICT accessible in order to compete. Suppliers that do not sell to government will be able to leverage on the standard to do what the government does in terms of procurement, but on a voluntary basis. In the next video, we will explain how procurement can be used to achieve accessibility, what you can expect from suppliers, and how you can control the deliverables. Thanks for watching.